Howdy, everyone. This is Uncle Ross from the backwoods. We're so far back in the backwoods, we don't even know where we are exactly. And we kind of gotten back in here because we kind of say stuff that the folks, they don't like. We say we're a bunch of redneck hillbillies, don't understand God and all that, you know. So that's where we're at here. But we have our own ways back here, you know. Not so sophisticated. But we spend our time listening to God, right? And God talks to us, tells us the truth. Now, I say to God, those other folks, they ain't gonna like the truth at all, you know? The preacher, the priest, they don't wanna hear this. So what am I supposed to do? God says, listen, he sent Jesus here and said, I'm the only son of God, you see. And God said, this means I only made one mind. There's only one creation of mine as my son, only one son, not two. And my son is divine. Divine mind is the only mind there is. There ain't no human mind and divine mind. This is what God says. And this is what God told me. He said, and I said, God, that those church folks, they ain't gonna like that. Because they say there's two natures, human and divine, and somehow they get joined together in a new creation of integration or something. This is what they think. And God says, I didn't say that. I never said that. There ain't no truth to that. And I said, but God, if there's only one mind, then what is all this other explanations? What is this all about? Is this too much to understand, huh? And God said, son, it's just lazy. It's just lazy. You can understand. You can get it. You just got to work at it. You know, you're kind of lazy, you gotten so lazy. I said, but if I start working on that, everybody's gonna look at me and say, what's Uncle Ross doing? You know, he's working so hard, industrious, you know, studying, thinking, praying, meditating, all this stuff. They say, he's working too hard, makes us look bad. God's gonna look down and gonna say, look at Uncle Ross down there. He's working really great, getting it all clear. You see, you can do it, right? And then all the rest of us got to look at us and say, hey, y'all down there, y'all lazy. You see, you can do it. Uncle Ross is doing it. How come you ain't doing it? Because you're lazy. So the people, they say, we don't want Uncle Ross doing nothing like that. We want him just get back in the backwoods, you know. Because it makes us all look bad, working too hard at the Lord, at the gospel. So they don't want no comparison. They don't want no comparisons. Makes them look bad. But what are we supposed to do? So there's only one mind, not two. That means we got a whole lot of work to do to get clear about what in the world is all this stuff about human mind, other mind, this whole hypostatic union, mysterious faith-based stuff. You got us this, say, mumbo jumbo, okay, the two became one, but they're still separate, but they're one in new creation. Da, 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 da. We're all kind of believing all that. Why? Because we're lazy. That's the belief of lazy folks. So what do lazy folk do? There's some very smart folks that, hey, we can get a lot of prestige if we help the lazy folks out and tell them, you know what? It's okay if you're lazy. We'll take care of it for you. We'll make it right. ride with God for you. So you just stay lazy, that's fine. God says, I like lazy people. And really, I like it. I like the, but you just come here to church, and we'll make it right with God. Don't worry about a thing. They don't want to hear this stuff, do they? No. And so we set up all these institutions, all these things for lazy, lazy, lazy people. They say, ah, it's too much work to understand how, what do we do? There's only one divine mind, and yet we have death and sickness and bodies in this world and all this stuff. And we can't understand how that. So just let us stay lazy, and you just fix it up for us, okay? And of course, the very sharpies, you know, real clever ones, they say, don't worry, we'll fix it up for you. Just help us out, we'll help you out. You scratch my back, I'll scratch your back, and it's all good. Don't worry. After you die, everything will be fine. So God's been telling me, that's all nonsense. And he says, you got no choice, but you got to get after it here and stop fooling around with all this nonsense. I say, wow, God. That's a mighty powerful preaching you're doing to me. But he put the fear of God in me and said, if you don't do it, guess what? You ain't getting nowhere. You're still gonna be shaking in a little corner somewhere in the dark. That's really amazing. I gotta do all this stuff. Okay, 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 okay. Maybe I got some time sitting here watching the plants grow. Maybe I can spend some time today, as a matter of fact. And so what God said is very simple. God said, that what we did, the Son of God, what the one Son of God did, is try to be better than God. Could you imagine that? Yeah. Try to be better than God. How did he try to do that? Try to change what he is. Son of God tried to change what he is. Tried to modify what he is. Because what God creates is eternal. All ideas in the mind of God are eternal. Never changing. So we tried to take the idea of the Son of God and change that idea. And in order to do this, we conjured up all this existence. We said, hey, light, freeze yourself and down into electromagnetism. And let's make a realm of electromagnetism and all this dynamics, supposedly dynamics and things. And we think maybe that's going to modify what we are, you see. So we asked the light to pretend to be modified. Pretend to be modified. Pretend to be energy, electromagnetic light. And then everything here is pretending like it's modified, you see. But it's only pretense. It's only pretending. So we dreamed all this up. It's really, we desire this realm. We desire this realm. We said, realm. We said, light, I want this realm. And the light said, so shall it be, Son of God. Whatever you ask, so shall you receive. So we received this realm. And then we think this realm is going to modify us, you you see. Modify the spirit that's under God. We're hoping all this stuff is going to modify us. So we're just kind of witnessing all this stuff that's happening here. We're not really this body, the personality, any of this realm at all. We're just a witness to it. We're spirit. We're just watching it. Just a watching and a waiting. Just a picking and a grinning. Like some hillbilly playing bluegrass music just up there on the hill, just waiting for the sun to set, you know. And we just are hoping that it will modify us, but you know what? It ain't gonna modify us. It ain't never gonna modify us. So we said, wow. Wow. But we're just the witness to all this realm. We ain't doing nothing here. We just have it all set up like a dream to make it seem to us that it's modifying us, that it might modify us someday. But it ain't never going to modify us, I tell you that. And now we're so used to watching this realm. We said we don't have this realm to watch over and look and hope for, you know. What are we going to do? What are we going to do in reality? So we're afraid to stop doing this, you know. It's like that. So God says, that's your problem. You're afraid you want to keep it going because I'm so used to this. I don't want to be without it, you know. We're so used to our misery. Hoping, fear. What do I do without that, God? This seems like so 360 everywhere. So this is our problem. Now those church folks, they don't want to hear that. In fact, nobody wants to hear it because they're all lazy. And they say, I don't want nobody contrasting with me, making me look bad. Shh, don't say nothing. Let's just keep a hoping. Let's just keep a picking and a grinning and a hoping and a fearing that it's all going to work out. We're going to be changed. We're going to be transformed. We're going to be modified. We're going to be integrated. We're going to be a new creation. All this, we're just hoping for that. And God said, we're hoping in vain. Hoping in vain. Ain't going to happen that way, folks. It's hot today, like the fires of hell today, I'm telling you. So in this world here, everybody says, shh, don't say nothing. God's just jealous. We got God fooled. We're going to change ourselves. Just wait and see. You just wait and see. There's a whole lot of misery coming in the world, a whole lot of despair. It's going to cause spirit to be changed. That's what we're thinking. Since we're my idea in the mind of God, eternal idea, if we think we can change it, that means we're greater than God, plain and simple. So God says our sin is arrogance. Thinking we can be greater than God. But we can't. We can't change who we are, so there ain't no sin really. Right? No harm, no foul, like we like to say. No harm, no foul. So nothing's ever happened. Everything's fine. God ain't angry at nobody. We're just got this continuity fear. We say, what do I do? I'm afraid. I got this realm, I have this dream realm. What do I do with it? Well, what you do with it is you let it just be the way that it is. But what you do, God said, you see everything as intrinsic spaciousness instead of form. So the form that we're seeing now is just decoration of intrinsic spaciousness is all it is. So there's all these different types of decorations of intrinsic spaciousness. But we don't see them as concrete, separate forms so much. They're just expressions of decoration everywhere. They're just decorating intrinsic spaciousness. So we see this existence like this, you see. And everything has this sameness of just being decorations. It's all beautiful decorations, so it's beautiful. But yet we see that there ain't no modification happening really, okay? Nothing's modifying intrinsic spaciousness, is it? So we need to be able to experience this, and we get to keep the structure of the realm kind of stays the same, but this, so we're not without it, you know? God told me all these things, all of this. So it's very simple, it's very easy. You just have to know what to do. So we just turn on the light here somehow, right? Boom, turn on the light like that. Intrinsic spaciousness, just like that. Ain't that cool? I think it's really cool. How'd they do that? I don't know how they do that. So those kind of the, I don't know how they do all that stuff, tell you the truth. But I don't really have to know how they did all that stuff, tell you the truth. Because all I got to see is this intrinsic spaciousness just, and everything is beautiful decorations of it, that's all it is. And everything feels very, very transparent. Like floating, everything's just floating. This wonderful transparency. Simple. So that's about it, you know? What else can I say? But them folks, out in the city folks, they don't like to hear this. They don't like me talking about it. They don't want to see me around. So I'm just kind of snuggling this, how do you say that? Smuggling this stuff out for you. From the backwoods, like cooking up in the still, you know, we're cooking some white lightning out here, way back in them hills. So you can be drinking that white lightning, the white lightning of truth. And you can say, white lightning. That's all, folks. Y'all come back, you hear? Sure enough, Uncle Ross here. Till next time, I'll be cooking up another batch of white lightning for you. Don't worry. That's what we do back here. What else are we gonna do back here, man? Ain't nothing else to do. I just help the revenue, a man don't catch us, you know. They gotta find us to catch us first, right? That's the thing.